Hi there again, Ian Cowan, taking you behind the scenes of Australian Open 2013. And we've got the trophies here. Have a look at this. This is the Norman Brooks Challenge Cup. And then we've got the Daphne Akhurst for the ladies as well. And the man who's going to talk us through how maybe one of the players can achieve this in 2 weeks' time is Pat Cash. Pat, thanks very much.
You're very welcome.
What does a player do now? We've had the draw. They know who they're playing. What actually happens now in the player's mind and with their entourage to gear up for Monday?
Well, you know, several things, of course. First of all, the most important thing is tactics. They'll be talking to their coach about how they're going to play the player. Maybe they'll be going even through some old video if they've got it. But you know, they've got to focus on their own game. They've got to get their game and their body in shape and ready, and particularly in the men, for potential five sets in heat. Who am I going to practice with? If it's a left-hander, if it's a baseliner, if it's a guy who's more attacking, he'll be searching out, I play an attacking player, let's go and get, you know, certain so-and-so to practice with. Many people talk about three parts of a tournament, you know, the first round, getting through the first round or first two, then the rest of the tournament, and then the end of the tournament. You are constantly adjusting the whole way through. So different players require different things. And, you know, if you've got to play one of the, Serena Williams, for instance, or something, you go, whoa, you know, one of some of the players will be thinking, I don't want to embarrass myself out there. I don't want to get beaten 6-love, 6-love. It's a tough ask. And then you see some of the other players, perhaps somebody like Sam Stosur, for instance, hasn't had a lot of matches under a belt, a few injuries, but his potential to do anything. So, you know, Sam will be focusing on just the things that she requires to do that she knows will get her into form.
What were you like when the draw unfolded 48 hours beforehand? Were you chilled out, relaxed, or were you sort of nervous chewing the nails?
Well, I usually didn't like that. I like to just see who I played that round. Wimbledon was really, really strange because the players used to get it on CFAX. Remember CFAX? You used to get the text on your. Some of the people here would no idea what CFAX
was. I've
got
no idea what you're talking about either. I'm not that
too
old.
Young. So we used to get on and sort of flick through the TV to see who you had to play. That was the most nervous moment, you know, to find out who you. So it's not very much fun looking down the draw, and it's even worse when you're not quite to see the draw on the printed out or whatever, and somebody comes up to you and goes, oh, did you know who you have to play? That's like, oh no, don't tell me. So a lot of the time you actually get the information before you get the chance to actually look at it yourself, and it's going to be interesting.
Pat, thanks for your time. Wimbledon
you
winner,
much.
Wimbledon winner Pat Cash on AATV.
Almost got my hands on this twice.
Nearly, almost. Do you think you can take it now?
Yeah, I got my hands. Oh, he's coming after me. Security guy's got me.
Pat Cash.